mission is obviously the way to go, and in the future it will grow as well.
I suppose I would see the decision of the society to invite lay people to come on mission was very, far-seeing and providential.
Lay people should also have a role in the church, and it's not just in their own local church, but also in the mission.
And they bring followers who, and previously, never had any interest at all in the church. They're coming up. They influenced them, and they have very, very good influence.
It's only right and proper that the Columbans should support the lay missionaries to take over, handing over the torch, so to speak.
But the example they've given us, their zeal and their commitment, has been an inspiration and a challenge to us.
I see their presence as an integral part of Columban mission.
The lay people experience God in their way, we experience in our own, and everybody has their own way of sending.
Believe in your mission. Believe that God is with you. And believe that the inspiration you feel in your heart is the way you need to go.
Fathers Edward Galvin and John Blowick, co-founders of the Missionary Society of St. Columban, from the very beginning envisioned laity. Sisters, brothers, and priests, all taking part in their missionary undertaking to China. But it wasn't until 1977 that the society began to explore ways for greater cooperation with the laity in cross-cultural mission. This cooperation has developed into a committed partnership with laity in mission through a Columban lay missionary movement. In 1990, the Columban Lay Missionary Program began. It evolved gradually through meetings with interested lay people and was formally approved by the society leadership in June 1994. At present, there are about 60 lay missionaries working in 12 countries in a variety of ministries, in areas of pastoral involvement in parishes, helping to share Christian communities, caring for migrants, working with people affected by HIV/AIDS, and interfaith dialogue. In this presentation, marking the 25th anniversary of the founding of the Columban Lay Mission Movement, we hear how this experience has changed their lives and faith perspective, both during and following their missionary journey.
We have 25 years experience of Columban lay missionaries. People often ask me, what's a lay missionary? And lay missionaries are lay people who have sensed that God is calling them to be missionaries, and they have joined the Columban lay mission movement. I think in the last 30, 40 years, there has been a renewal of our understanding of who is called to be a missionary. In the past, I think, when I was young, certainly we tended to think that it was mainly priests and sisters were missionaries. But in fact, our new understanding of the sacrament of baptism, we realise that everybody is called to be a missionary, and not everybody gets the opportunity. But today, in the church around the world, it's great to see so many lay people are coming forward to be missionaries. On a personal level, I just would like to congratulate all the Columban lay missionaries. Personally, I had a great opportunity when I was a young missionary in Taiwan that we had lay missionaries come to Taiwan. We have had lay missionaries in Korea, Philippines, all in many of our countries. But the example they've given us, their zeal and their commitment, has been an inspiration and a challenge to us. Sometimes maybe we were getting a little bit complacent as priests and sisters, but certainly when we saw these young people, it was a challenge to us, and their encouragement that they've given us is obvious to see.
Yes, as you know yourself, Maliki, kind of in our 1982 chapter down in Lima, Peru, the Columbans decided to start taking on vocations from the countries that we work in. Then the Pope here came here to Korea in 1984 and to celebrate 200 years, and he emphasized, and so did Korean theologians after that, for 200 years we have received. Now it's time we started sharing out. So in 1985 we started taking in seminarians here. And 1988 or 89 we started taking in lay missionaries here. Anyway, since 25 years ago then, we're celebrating 25 years in Korea this year, we start taking in lay missionaries here in Korea. Here, their main work for lay missionaries here is they live in poor areas, in squatter areas. Our missionaries go into the Philippines as well, the same way. We just had a sharing the other day from Columban Chang, one of the first lay missionaries from Korea here, who went to the Philippines after 25 years. She's just an ordinary lady, you could say, at this stage. But live with the poor, work with the poor, work with disadvantaged people, worked in Myanmar, and now is going back, starting a new mission in Myanmar. A very humble, and again, one of her great messages was, I cursed God at times, she says, because life was so hard. I cursed God for the poverty in the Philippines and the people who are dying. But through all this, she met a new God, a new faith, and most of us would be humbled before her to hear her sharing her message, her life. People ask, why lay missionaries instead of priests? The lay people experience God in their way. We experience in our own, and everybody has their own way of presenting it.
The lay missionary movement in Lima has been very successful. It has been very successful in identifying the people who can do mission and the people who can't, you know. Now, I must say that the people who have come to us from the Philippine Islands and from Fiji have been very, very successful. And I think the reason why for that is because they can sympathize with the poor, and they can dialogue with them. They bring followers who previously never had any interest at all in the church. They're coming out. Why? Because they can form friendships. They can form friendships, they can convince they're into right, and they bring them along. They influence them, and they have very, very good influence. But I would say this now, I know one North American lay missionary who has been very successful. And why? Because he was able to enter into the organizational structure of the church, and he could help direct and guide. And he has rendered great service. Right now, I'm very disappointed that when I was leaving Peru last year, there were only two Filipino lay missionaries. They were working away, they were very happy. But I would like to see 22 lay missionaries there, you know.
And so for a long time it was, my focus was really to live in a place called Chamiran in Shanbog, an area that the Columbans worked in Lahore behind the railway station, get to know the people I was living among. A lot of the community that I lived among would have been working as sweepers and janitors, would have had, a difficult enough lot in life. And through one thing and another, I got involved with a local youth group. I got involved in a small health initiative that kind of spiraled over time through contacts through some of the Columbans, with a Dr. Purves Avan in Services Hospital, and started an accompaniment program, accompanying people who needed health. And to cut a very long story short, Dr. Avan and some of his friends agreed to come over to Shanbog, where I was living, and started a clinic one day a week, a free clinic where people could come and get a proper consultation. They noticed that there were a lot of difficulties with eye cataract problems, so he contacted a cousin of his, Dr. Hamid, who started doing free operations for people. And then there are other examples as well, things you don't recognise. I mean, obviously, there are issues that you could talk about in Pakistan around gender equality, maybe in any country in the world, including Ireland. And that wasn't an issue that I addressed directly, but yet, through the way in which you live, people notice. And I can remember one friend of mine, young guy, a few years younger than myself, in his early 20s, Fiaz, one day he said to me, you know, last night I saw my mother and my sisters in a different way, because I realized after supper every evening, myself and my father and my brother sit back and we watch the cricket or whatever's on television, and we leave them do the wash up and cleaning up after cooking our meal. And yesterday evening I realized, well, Seamus does his own cooking and he washes his own dishes, so why can't I do that? And I tried to help, and my mother got the dishcloth and she hit me a whack with the dishcloth and said, what do you want to be doing that for? You're a man, that's not your job. But so obviously you don't change something like that overnight, but it does show through a simple witness, through a simple, just doing my own thing, as simple as washing my own dishes. Fiaz noticed that and it changed something in terms of his thinking, which hopefully has an impact now in terms of his, how he engages with his wife and his kids and his family over time.
Basically, as a lay missionary, I lived within a community in Sinacabin for 3 years first, with Joe MacDonald. I was in the parish with Joe, so I was very much involved with the people and the community, living in the community, and just first of learning the language and being there and living very simply with the people. So I got to know the families and people that had lost loved ones, or people that with disabilities or any form of vulnerability that needed someone to listen to or talk to. I am a social worker, but I lived with the people and I got to know their lives and their struggles and their journeys. So as a lay missionary, I lived washing my clothes at the well with the women. So it was very part attending prayer and just living their lives and getting to know about their lives. I really feel being a lay missionary, it changed my life. It made, we were saying last night that the struggles of the journey, but the struggles is getting to know you and getting to know what God wants from you. Yeah, I would do it all again tomorrow, although it was hard and a struggle. Yeah, it changed my life to be more open and spiritual and to work more with the urban poor. And that's what I've been doing since I've left, you know, working with abused women and stuff like that. Yeah.
Well, this was a real exploration, I suppose, because, you know, your ideas of mission are a bit confused, perhaps, before you actually experience it. I mean, I wasn't too sure at the beginning whether I'd be going out knocking on doors. On the other hand, we were told that, you know, just be yourself, and that's really what we did. We went out and worked. We were Irish Catholics, and we were experiencing life in Korea, as Catholics, I suppose you call it. And that's where the element, the lay element, was attractive to me when I saw the advertisement for it, and the fact that you could do it as an ordinary person. I thought, well, okay, this is something that I could commit to for a period of time, and I could just be myself, but I could also explore questions of faith in it.
Involving the lay people with the Columbans as lay missionaries was a good move. Lay people are, as we know, make up the very majority of the church membership, so involving them in lay mission, in mission, is always obviously the way to go, and in the future it will grow as well. And I think over the years, certainly the involvement of lay missionaries here in Korea has helped us priest missionaries in regard to the way we understand our work, and also, of course, interacting with lay people, because the lay missionaries are closer, they're more in the team with us, in closer partnership than perhaps maybe even lay people in the parish. And that has been a challenge, but it also has been a good thing and a learning experience for all of us. In a very broken society that the world is at the present time, lay missionaries crossing boundaries of culture and language, like other missionaries, are a very valuable thing, a valuable aspect of modern life. The two things are going, there's great violence throughout the world and war, but the presence of missionaries and lay missionaries as well in lots of countries, that's helpful too. But I think actually missionaries, that's probably the thing that we're learning, that mission can be anywhere and indeed should be anywhere, and that that mix of people from another culture and another Christian tradition is very helpful and very enriching. And basically what I think it needs, what it demands, is a certain amount of openness everywhere, in the recipient and in the person who is going. In the recipient, in the case of Irish people, learning from the spirituality and the openness and the willingness or generosity of people from other cultures and other missionary countries, other countries, that's very helpful. And the missionary who goes, let's say, from the Philippines to Ireland, meets up with Irish people too, meets up with the faith and their expression of it, and that person is helped and enriched. So there is an enrichment going both ways. But at times, it isn't easy, actually. Both sides are challenged, and both people have to overcome some difficulty. Perhaps maybe the first one is language, the other one naturally would be certain ways of doing things. Yeah.
And we have had a number of lay missionaries from Fiji and from the Philippines and from Korea over that period of time. Their role, in actual fact, is, I suppose, in Ireland, is to be part of the Columban mission outreach in Ireland itself. They have their own identity as lay missionaries. So their role in Ireland particularly is, at currently there are only two, regretfully, one is working in Ballymun in parishes, in the parish of Ballymun at the Columban parish in Dublin, and that's Lorelei, and Lorelei is here 7 years now, and she is involved very much in the whole pastoral outlet there in Ballymun. Ballymun is a Columban parish in Dublin, and it's going for well over, I don't know exactly how many years, but it's, I suppose, when we took on this parish, we were very keen that we would have an outreach to maybe the poorer people in Dublin, and Ballymun was such a place. So Lorelei is involved with youth there in the parish. Angie, at this moment of time, is the coordinator of the two of the lay mission in Ireland as well, movement, and she has worked in parishes as well. But now she is also the coordinator of the lay mission, and as well as that, she is a member of the mission promotion awareness outreach team. But what I like to see is that they are part of an outreach team of Columbans. And in the past year, I set up a small group with a possible new structure, particularly for those engaged in outreach, to a mission outreach in Ireland. And so the two lay missionaries are very much connected with this small group of trying to figure out, well, what is Columban mission in Ireland at the moment? We have a little centre in Dublin which we opened there a few years ago. It's a joint venture between the Columban sisters, the lay missionaries, and Columban priests. I think there's a whole change, a mind change in Ireland. It's a very different Ireland to the Ireland that we were involved in here, that I grew up in. I believe Ireland, because of culture and everything like that, attitudes towards church, is a changed reality, and I consider myself very much on mission here in Ireland, and that's where I would like to see more as well involved.
I'm able to kind of mark my place, kind of mark my place in the place, you know, in Ballymun. So I've been there for 7 years, and it gave me the sense of maybe this real mission in Ballymun. You know, they have the chance and they're given the opportunity to really be, to develop themselves and to really rise up from the reputation of being, you know, not the best one. So that's it. So in that sense, in that culture, in that situation, I'm able to see myself and also kind of understand maybe, you know, the dynamics, the culture of Ballymun people. And at the same time, they're able to see me as somebody that's maybe different from them, but can be together, you know, can, that are different, but we can share and integrate things.
As I've said, whenever there is poverty, material and spiritual poverty in the world, there's always a need of mission. And nowadays, especially here in Ireland, when the church could have been in a difficult situation and there's a lack of priests and all that, so I'm sure it's strengthening the, you know, what the laity can offer to the church. So I'm sure the Columban Lay Mission will always be here. And that's, of course, also in God's grace and with the support and the trust and confidence of the Columban priest in the work of the lay missionaries. As a coordinator of the lay mission here in Ireland, I'm the one who is communicating all the what is going on in the lay mission here in Ireland. Like this, we have receiving and sending programs. So when we say receiving, that means lay missionaries from other countries will come to Ireland, like myself, who came to Ireland in 1999. So there is a kind of an orientation program for those who are coming here for about 2 months before they'll be assigned to their place of assignment, like parishes. So that's the receiving program. And then the sending program then is for Irish lay missionaries who are trying to be part of the Columbans, and then they'll be sent to countries like Chile and Philippines and some of those countries where lay missionaries are invited to come over. At the moment we have Ocean Kenny. He just finished his final review of the orientation program, so that means he started coming to Dalgan for discernment and accompaniment since last year, and he officially started the orientation program in September, and now he's ready to go for mission in Chile.
Well, I think it's only right and meet and proper that the Columbans, who have been supported so well by the lay people from the beginning of our societies, financially and with their prayers and their sacrifices, and now those, that whole generation is beginning to die off, replaced by a certain number, but not the same numbers as originally. It's only right and proper that the Columbans should support the lay missionaries to take over, handing over the torch, so to speak, because the traditional Columban missionaries, the priests and the sisters, numbers have gone way down, and they can be could be very profitably replaced. I had 33, I think it was, altogether over the years, lay people who came here and worked. Well, we wouldn't have succeeded here at all without their help. It would have collapsed the whole thing, I suspect.
Good morning, everyone. The Columban Lay Missions here in Ireland is delighted to join Dalgan community to celebrate today's Mass. This weekend is a special occasion for the lay missions to gather Irish and British returned lay missionaries from the Philippines, Taiwan, Korea, China, Pakistan, and Chile.
together with the families, and also lay missionaries who were assigned here in Ireland and made Ireland their home. There are many things that we would like to thank God for in this Eucharistic celebration, especially the 25th year anniversary of the founding of Columban Lay Missions all over the world. 25 years of following Christ and keeping on God's mission in partnership with the ordained Columbans. Also, we thank God for the friendship we have built over the last 2 years and the bonding as members of the Columban family.
Involving them in lay mission, in mission is always obviously the way to go, and in the future it will grow as well.
I suppose I would see the decision of the society to invite lay people to come on mission was very, far-seeing and providential.
Lay people should also have a role in the church, and it's not just in their own local church, but also in the mission.
And they bring followers who, and previously, never had any interest at all in the church. They're coming up. They influenced them, and they have very, very good influence.
It's only right and proper that the Columbans should support the lay missionaries to take over, handing over the torch, so to speak.
But the example they've given us, their zeal and their commitment, has been an inspiration and a challenge to us.
I see their presence as an integral part of Columban mission.
The lay people experience God in their way we experience in our own, and everybody has their own way Sunday.
Believe in your mission. Believe that God is with you. And believe that the inspiration you feel in your heart is the way you need to go.